Alrighty, folks, welcome here to Scotiabank Pond. Sunday night hockey between your Toronto Junior Canadiens and the visiting Brampton Admirals. Jaron Klugman alongside Brendan Heiser for the call on this one. We'll see the Admirals on the power play, 18.7%, 8th best in the OJHL. Canadiens penalty kill, 84.5%, that's 9th best in the Ontario Junior Hockey League as Delvecchio carries in. He gets stapled down by Liam Fedak. LePage in forehand, and this line has been pretty active in this one. There's a pass that goes all the way around. Spencer trying to get back. Oh, what a play by Chase Spencer. Canadiens look to try and exploit that as it goes to Hill at the line. He'll send it over to Spencer. Spencer waits, looks for a lane, goes for a skate, and he drops it off to Katosha. Katosha from the top of the dot gets the shot away and scores. Oh, what a goal. Great release by Ryan Katosha. Gets the Canadiens on the board, and they take the 1-0 lead.
Yeah, and that's exactly what I was talking about before. On the Junior Canadiens power play, they had to look to get more shots on net, and that's exactly what Katosha did there. He had some room, picked his spot, and sniped it perfectly into the top corner. 1-0, Jersey.
28 seconds left on the penalty to Fedak. Stoichevsky with it, enters the Canadiens line, trying to flip it around. Mansurov sent him down to the Scotiabank Pond ice surface. It's out by Katosha, and he gets it down the ice as Smith is going to come out of his net. Haynes looked to play it. It's given away, though. O'Brien picks it off, trying to toe drag his way in shorthanded. It was broken up by Deacon Holmes, who has to be careful. Gives it away to Cesare. Oh, and he put it just wide of the net. As the season gets deeper, these penalties can sometimes determine seeding based on a point. And as you mentioned yesterday, with the late power play goal that was scored by the Patriots, leading to them collecting a point as Delvecchio brings it in, trying to center it. It hit the side and it goes in somehow there. Delvecchio sent it from behind the net, not sure who hit it, and it's Delvecchio leading the charge. Hit the back of Shepard, went in the net, and as I said, this could prove costly. Brampton proves just exactly that. 1-1 the score.
Yeah, puck was just sent what looked to be innocently out of the corner by Delvecchio. I think it hit off the skate of Tanner Shepard and banked into the net.
Coming in over the line, Holmes gets a shot away, made the stop with Shepard, out in front. Oh, what a save, Stephen Kalisti. Give him the goaltending job. Big hit there by Holmes as he sent Amaral down. Delvecchio now takes it back out to the top. Still on it, keeps it. Knocked away, and now he trips up Redding. No call there. Oh, there is a call coming up. Kalisti drops it off, falls, trying to carry his way in. It's stopped by Smith as he makes the save. Hill to O'Brien. It's tipped out near center. This gets by Del Mastro. O'Brien trying to beat him towards the puck as he cuts him off. Katosha rolls and grabs it behind the Brampton net. Into the corner. He gets it out to the line. Georgiev with a clapper. That stopped. DeGasperis on the rebound. Smith down, and it's between his legs. He covers it up. Off of the draw, it goes back to Heiser. His shot tipped on the way through. Claudio DeGasperis scores on the deflection. Heiser's shot. It's 2-1 Canadiens on a great play from the line right off the faceoff draw. Heiser got the shot through. DeGasperis with the tip, and it's 2-1 for the JRC.
Yeah, great play right off the faceoff, and you can feel it coming. With Spencer taking the shot on the previous faceoff, but right off the draw. It comes to the point to Heisler, who takes a shot, and it gets tipped in by DeGasperis. Great goal, and JRC flying here to start the third as they lead 2-1.
Redding kept it in at the line, sends it over to Georgiev, who takes it, goes behind the Brampton net. Georgiev in there, still with no room really to get a shot away. He'll take it back up to the top. Over now to Spencer. What a shot! Oh, Chase Spencer! Are you kidding me? 3-1 to the JRC! And I mentioned Georgiev had no angle for the shot because Chase Spencer reached back into the bag of tricks and fired that top cheese. What a goal!
And as great of a shot as it was for Spencer, you have to look at the play made by Georgiev and compliment him on his patience. He never had an angle to shoot, but he held on to that puck and waited for his teammate Chase Spencer to get an angle.
Barkley steals it right back from him. Now forehand trying to jump in. Gets back up to the line. Holmes with a drive, and that went high and over the net as LePage trying to get it up ahead for forehand. That got by him. Holmes back in his own end. Stolen by Mansourov. Mansourov walks in. LePage trying to get the shot up, and he did. It was Smith with a save. Another stop. Smith comes all the way out. Makes the save. Diving there to keep it out. Mansourov knocked that down. Allaire backhands it over to Del Vecchio. Saucer pass across as they re-enter the line. It's Rodas coming in. Takes it with one hand on the stick to the corner. Mansourov comes in to help out. Forehand trying to get it out near the line. Cavalieri stopped it. It's a moot point as it goes down the ice. And the Toronto Junior Canadiens, 4-1 is the score. LePage trailing, now comes in over the line, drops it off. Lombardi walks in, sends it back. LePage sent that just wide as that was drawn up very well in the final few seconds. Georgiev takes a long shot. Smith makes the save. It doesn't matter. Your Toronto Junior Canadiens win this game. 4-1 the final score. 23-6, 2-3 for Brendan Heisler and Michael Huth. I'm Jaron Kligman. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next weekend.